Hey everyone, today I'm showing you 5 chokers that you can make at home. I really like chokers, but I feel like they're so overpriced everywhere, and these are made out of stuff that you can find in your crafts box or your local craft store, and I really like how they turned out, so I'm going to show you how I made them. So the first one is going to be the easiest out of all of them. The first one is a suede lace choker, and you're literally just going to need some suede laces and a pair of scissors. I didn't have a measuring tape around, so I wrapped this around my neck to see how long it has to be, and then I cut it. And as you can see, it still is in a really weird shape. So I used some hot water and put all of the measured and cut suede laces in it and let it sit for about 15 minutes. That's me stabbing the suede laces. And let it sit and then dry it. I put it in the dryer to dry it, but you can let it air dry if you want. And then you just tie this around your neck however you like to, and that's really it. Next is the ribbon choker. You're gonna need a little bit more stuff with this. You're gonna need ribbons, ribbon clamps, clasps, jump rings, pliers, and a liner. For this choker, you're going to want to cut it a little bit shorter than how wide your neck is, because you're gonna need to put clasps and attachments on it. Then you wanna use a lighter to get rid of all the frays on the ribbons on both sides, and get a ribbon clamp of the right size. Slide that ribbon into the ribbon clamp and then tighten it. Make sure that it doesn't slip out. And you gotta do this for both ends of the ribbon. After it's tightened, take a clasp with the jump ring and then put the clasp through the jump ring. And it doesn't matter which kind of clasp you wanna use. And then just attach the jump ring to the clamp and then tighten it, close the jump ring. This was a little tricky to do. It took me a couple of tries, but you'll get the hang of it. And then on the other end, just do the exact same thing, but with another jump ring or something to put the clasp into, so you can close the choker. And you can do this with other ribbons as well. Next is the thin rhinestone choker, and you're just gonna need a rhinestone chain with attachments. Usually it comes with the attachments so that it can connect to jump rings, but if not, you can just get them. And you're gonna need clasps and jump rings and pliers. So you're gonna cut and measure this the same way you did with the ribbon choker, and you wanna attach both of the ends to the connector so that we can add clasps to it. You wanna tighten it, and this was like the hardest thing to do because I just got my nails done and this is really tiny if you can't tell, so it was kind of hard. Next, you wanna attach the jump ring with clasps to the chain, and you can use whatever clasp you want and just close the jump ring like you did earlier with the ribbon choker. For the other end without the clasp, just make sure that the connector's hole is big enough for the clasp to attach to so that you can close the choker. Next is the thick rhinestone choker, and this is my personal favorite out of all of the other chokers. First, you're gonna need a rhinestone trim. I chose one that has 4 rows of rhinestones because I think that that's the thickest that it can be without it being uncomfortable to wear. And you're gonna do the same thing as the ribbon and rhinestone choker. You're just gonna cut it a little bit shorter than the width of your neck. And if you're lazy with this, you can use Velcro, but I decided to use ribbon clamps because I think it's a little bit sturdier. And I'm really doing the same thing. I'm getting a ribbon clamp that fits the width of the rhinestone trim and then tightening it with pliers. And I'm doing this on both ends. Next, I'm just attaching clasps like I did with the past 2 chokers. You're just gonna put the clasp in the jump ring and attach it to the choker, and then use a pair of pliers to close the jump ring. I especially like this choker because I just feel like Audrey Hepburn when I wear it. Next is the popular fabric choker, and you're just gonna lay out fabric of whichever color you like and then glue the top edge. I tried to use fabric glue at first and it came right off, so just use your super glue that you have lying around in your house. And take the bottom edge and fold it to the top. And I just pressed it gently to make sure that it's really glued together. And I was worried about super glue being too hard for a fabric choker, but I think it worked fine. And then you want to roll it inside out so all the ugly edges don't show. Next, tuck in both ends of the choker and then glue it together. Also, I think I cut my fabric uneven or something, but the middle part is a little bit more narrow, but we're just gonna ignore that for now. Then you wanna put on the Velcro on both sides and make sure that it's the right size and doesn't stick out. and I'm gonna super glue that shit on my choker. And make sure to do it on the opposite side, on the opposite end. And try to not make the same mistake I did and make the middle part so narrow, but that's really it. I hope you found this video helpful. I spent a lot of effort on this, so I hope you give it a like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. If you decide to make any of these, please, please, please tag me in pictures of them because I would love to see how you wear them. Oh, and by the way, I just made my Snapchat public, so if you want to go on there and look at my stories, that would be nice. I would love to get snaps of your pet. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.